فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We're in our كتاب الورقات للإمام الحرمين أبي معالي الجويني رحمه الله. We finally, الحمد لله, we finished talking about the definition of usul and al-fiqh. And we also talked about ahkam al-shar'iyya, al-taklifiyya, and ahkam al-shar'iyya, al-wad'iyya. And we spoke about the five that came out of ahkam al-taklifiyya, and also the two that came out of ahkam al-wad'iyya. We spoke about it, alhamdulillah. Then we also spoke about مراتب الإدراك, the levels of perceptions. And we took how many?
Six.
We took six. العلم والجهل. جهل is two times. جهل مركب وجهل بسيط. We took شك, ظن and وهم. Those were the six that we took. Inshallah ta'ala, today we're going to go into what? أصول and fiqh together. What does it mean? What does أصول and fiqh together mean? That's what we're going to study. تعريف أصول الفقه وأبوابه. So this chapter, inshallah, is going to teach us what does أصول الفقه actually mean? One. And also, what does أصول الفقه talk about? That's what we're going to learn. So I'm going to read the matn of Al-Imam Al-Haramain. Then I'm going to go to the speech of Abdullah ibn Salih Al-Fawzan, who is sharah we rely on. So, inshallah, pay attention. وعلم أصول الفقه, the knowledge of أصول الفقه, ها طرقه, its evidences are على سبيل الإجمال, its evidences are general evidences, وكيفية الاستدلال بها, and how, كيفية الاستدلال بها, it is how to benefit, كيفية, the way to use those general evidences, how to use them and apply them. That's the second thing. So the first one was what? Brothers and sisters, I want you to pay attention. أصول الفقه deals with three things. The first one is, and Al-Imam Al-Haramain, he missed the third one. But when Abdullah ibn Salih Al-Fawzan adds it to the sharah. The first one is, طرقه على سبيل الإجمال. طرق means, it's the same as adilla. طرق and adilla are the same. We'll see it in the sharah, inshallah ta'ala. طرقه, its evidences are what? General evidences. One. What was fiqh? Its evidences were what? Specific evidences. أصول الفقه is what? General evidences. Good. One. Second one is what? وكيفية الاستدلال بها. Those general evidences, how do you benefit from them? And how do you use them? How do you apply them? Is the second thing أصول الفقه will teach you. The third one he left, which is what? وحال المستفيد. And the conditions of the مجتهد. And matters pertaining to the مجتهد. وحال المستفيد is what? The condition of the مجتهد. The conditions of who?
Mujtahid.
The mujtahid. That's the definition of usul al-fiqh. The second part that he's talking about here, that's the first thing which was the definition. وَأَبْوَابُهُ. What are the chapters? What are the chapters that usul al-fiqh will deal under? What chapters would you come across? وَأَبْوَابُ usul al-fiqh. The chapters of usul al-fiqh are, and I'm not going to explain them, I'm just going to read them, because each one we're going to stand over. First one is called what? Pay attention. It's meant to be 23 in total. He left two, and I will add that to it, inshallah ta'ala. Al-Imam al-Haramain, he left two, and I will add it to it, inshallah ta'ala. The first one is what? Aqsamul kalami, one. Aqsamu Al-Kalami, types of speeches. The first one is what? Aqsamul Kalami. The second one is what? Al-Amru, command. The third one is what? Prohibitions, Al-Nahyu. The fourth one is what? Al-Ammu. The fifth one is what? Am means what? Fourth one means Am means general. Fifth one is what? Al-Khasu, specific. The sixth one is Al-Mujmal, the ambiguous evidences. Al-Mubayyan is the seventh one, is the clarified one. The next one is Al-Zahiru, the apparent. Al-Zahiru, the apparent. The one after that is Al-Mu'awwal. Mu'awwal is the interpreted one. Al-Af'alu, actions. Al-Nasikh, the abrogator. The next one, Wal-Mansukhi, the one that's been abrogated. The next one, Al-Ijma'u, consents. Al-Ijma'u, consents. The one after that, Al-Akhbaru, news. The one after that, Al-Qiyasu, analogy. Al-Qiyasu, analogy. The book is in the same order as how he says it. Every chapter we go like that in the order. The chapter, the one after analogy, Qiyas is what? Al-Hadhru. Prohibited something from you. There's a difference between Nahi and Hadar. We'll come to it, inshallah. The one after that is called Ibaha. Permission. To be permitted something. The next one is what? Tartibul Adilla. The sequences of the evidences. The one after permission is what? The sequences of the evidences. The one after that is called Sifatul Mufti. The conditions of the Mufti. The conditions of who? The Mufti. The next one after that is the condition of the one that's asking the question of to the Mufti. It's called Mustafti. The one who's asking the fatwa. And the last one, which is the 21st one, is Ahkamul Mujtahideena. Ahkamul Mujtahideena. The rulings of the Mujtahids. The Mujtahids' rulings. He left two. What did he leave? He left off Al-Mutlaq, which is the 22nd. And then the 23rd one, which is Al-Muqayyad. Al-Mutlaq is an open evidence, and Al-Muqayyad is a narrowed down evidence. 23 things Usulul Fiqh is what we're going to go through, inshallah ta'ala. That is the matn. That is the matn of Al-Imam Al-Haramayn, rahimahullah. Just the last two, Mutlaq and Muqayyad, I added that to it. And inshallah ta'ala, we're now going to take the sharah of Abdullah ibn Salih al-Fawzan of every point that he mentioned. Now we're taking it as what? This is looking at it from the angle of the perspective of what? لقب لهذا الفن. As a name, as a title for this topic. أصول الفقه. That's the heading. This topic is called أصول الفقه. As for individual, what they mean, we've taken that. We've taken what أصول meant, لغة واصطلاحا. We've taken فقه what it meant, لغة واصطلاحا. We took it. جميل. So now we're taking what فقه, أصول الفقه means together. Analyze what he said. pay attention. The sharah. علم أصول الفقه. The science of أصول الفقه is طرق. طرق is the plural of the word طريقة. It's a plural. And it's the plural of the word طريقة. طرق is the plural of the word طريقة. طريقة means what? Path. Here it's meant by what? It means أدلة الفقه الإجمالي. It means the general fiqh evidences. Fiqh brothers, the first one of the definitions, remember? It deals with what? Principles which are general. The usuli, he doesn't look at the matter individually. He doesn't. That's not his job. Who looks at everything specifically and generally? The faqih does. The person who deals with fiqh, what he does is, he goes through all the points in fiqh. What we're doing, umdatul ahkam, that's called fiqh. You might not take everything. When we're talking about salah, do we have anything to do with zakat? No. Lakin the usuli, he finds a principles where salah, zakat, hajj, sawm, all of them fall under. Such as, al-amru, a command, indicates obligation. That is a principle which is an usuli principle. That usuli principle, it can be applied in tahara. If a command is found in the chapters of tahara, the evidence can be applied. One. If it's found in the chapter of, if a command comes regarding the prayer, it was also implemented in salah. Zakat, hajj, sawm, mu'amalat and uqud. It doesn't matter. Here's that principle. It is used everywhere. He sticks with things that are general evidences. See how general it is? Because it enters everywhere. Are you with me? Faqih, the usuli, this is how he is. So his evidences are how? They are general evidences. Like al-amru lil-wujub. Wal-nahyu lil-tahrim. The amr, it shows obligation. Prohibitions show that it's haram. Also, ijma' is a hujjah. When the usuli says to you, ijma' is a hujjah, mathalan, he doesn't care where the ijma' comes into. Whether it's, if it's tahara, or it's salah, or the ijma' is found in kitab, it doesn't matter. Walidhalik Ibn al-Munzir, he wrote a book called what? Al-Ijma'. And what he did is, he organized that book in the way he mentions all the ijma' in tahara, all the ijma' in salah, all the ijma'at. You go and you study. So when you learn usul al-fiqh, you don't have to follow every branch. Alhamdulillah, you're here, a person comes up to you and says to you, gives you a hadith. You've probably never heard of this hadith before. Are you with me? Yes. You've never heard of it. And the hadith, for example, you've never heard of the hadith of the messenger, إِذَا دَخَلَ أَحَدُكُمُ الْمَسْجِدَ فَلَا يَجْلِسَ حَتَّى يُصَلِّي رَكْعَتَيْنِ. If one of you enters the masjid, he should not sit down until he prays two. Are you with me? So here, you know usul al-fiqh. And you have a principle which is وَالنَّهْيُ لِلْتَحْرِيمِ. Prohibition, it shows that it's haram. So this person says to you, brother, this hadith. You say to him, according to the hadith that you have given me, it is haram for a person to sit down if he enters the masjid. You with me? You've never heard of this. But because you have a adilla ijmaliyya, adilla which is general, you can apply it on any place that it fulfills that requirement of that principle. Like in the faqih, he struggles. If he hasn't seen something that he knew, he can't give a ruling on it. Because he hasn't got what? He hasn't got the qawa'id to bring all of this together. So that's why it's important to study usul al-fiqh. You see? So this subject, this is the things that they research. Good. وَأَمَّا أَدِلَّةُ التَّفْصِيلِيَّةِ ونحو ذلك من المسائل الكلية التي تبحث في أصول الفقه. أما الأدلة التفصيلية, which is the opposite, أدلة إجمالية, الأدلة التفصيلية. أدلة التفصيلية, which is the fiqh, what they deal with, فلا تذكر في أصول الفقه. أدلة تفصيلية is not mentioned. أدلة تفصيلية is not mentioned in أصول الفقه إلا على سبيل التمثيل والإيضاح. Only as an example. Only as an example. But it's not based a ruling on it. So for example, now that I said to you, the order, it shows obligation. What did I apply? What did I just show you now? I used the salah as an example. The fact that I used the salah automatically became tafsili, because the salah is a specific field in the fiqh, right? Because salah is a zakat. It's specific. But I only used it to explain the principle of usul for you. Pay attention. That's why. وَأَقِيمُ Such as the speech of Allah, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ Establish the prayer, وَآتُ الزَّكَاةِ And give the zakat. Here is an order. Yes. Does it show obligation? It shows obligation. Now. Such as what? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed the salah in what? In the Kaaba. The Prophet, what did he do? He prayed the salah in the what? Inside the Kaaba. Inside the Kaaba he prayed. This is an example. This is an example. يُمَثَّلُ بِهِ It's used لِلْفِعْلِ When we go to the chapter, inshallah, al-af'al, actions of the Prophet, we will talk about it. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُعَمْ No one's allowed to generalize this. It's called قَضِيَّةُ عَيْنِ لَا عُمُوَ لَهَا It's a specific incident and you can't generalize it. Qawa'id are going to be brought out. There's a principle that's there. So a person tells you that the Prophet did this once. You say to him, قَضِيَّةُ عَيْنِ لَا عُمُوَ لَهَا Don't try to bring evidences from one in-off scenario that the Prophet did something. You can't bring a general ruling out of it. Some scholars, they take that stance. You see? Pay attention. وَعَبَّرَ الْمُصَنِّفُ He said that the Musannif, he chose to use the word طُرُقُهُ عَلَى سَبِيلِ الْإِجْمَالِ So he used the word طُرُق, طُرُقُ الْفِقْهِ He used that word. Then using the word أَدِلَّةُ الْفِقْهِ Instead of using the word أَدِلَّةُ evidence, he used the word طُرُق path. And again, we said it's the same. بِنَاءً And this is based upon what? عَلَى الْمَشْؤُورِ عِنْدَهُمْ That which is famous with him, which is... The Ash'ariya khubth is just coming out now. We have to realize, this is called, I have to realize, this is a lawthatul Ash'ariya. The Ash'a'ira, as we took before, if you pay attention, usul al-fiqh is very important. What did the Ash'a'ira do? They distinguish between a dalil and an amara, a sign. A dalil is the evidence for them, and there's something called a sign, according to them. So they're trying to say that these qawa'id, these adillah, these evidences, for them is based upon what? It's only amarat. They are not evidences in and within itself. You can reject it if you want. Why? Because it's based upon dhan. It's not based upon ilm. Only the thing that's based upon ilm, which is mutawatir, those are the only things, or like that, is the only things which they believe is evidence. As for ijtihad, when it comes into it, striving, they say this is not an evidence. This is an amara. It's a sign for the evidence. So what happens? Automatically they drop it. And we refuted that when we spoke about it before. That's a weak of the Ash'a'ira in which they have. Second point is what? وَكَيْفِيَّةُ الْإِسْتِسَوْتِ The usage of the word طُرُقُ is not good. I'll leave that word. So what do you use? Adilla is better for you to use. Because it has that element of the Ash'ariya there. وَكَيْفِيَّةُ الْإِسْتِدْلَالِ بِهَا So we talked about Adillatul Ijmaliyah. We finished that one. The second point of Usul al-Fiqh was what? وَكَيْفِيَّةُ How can a person... Here is the evidence. How can you benefit from it? How can you benefit from the dalil that you have? How can you benefit from it? How can you benefit from it? And the third one, which is what? وَحَالُ الْمُسْتَفِيدِ And the situation of the one who is using the evidence. Inshallah ta'ala, when we talk about كَيْفِيَةُ الْإِسْتِدْلَالِ How to benefit from the text. The person has to know what? دَلَالَاتُ الْأَلْفَاظِ This is the topic that deals with what? How to benefit from the text. Are you with me? دَلَالَاتُ الْأَلْفَاظِ We're going to go into it. What does the word man? What does it benefit? What does the word ma? What does it benefit? If it's in a siyaq, if it's in a context of affirmation, or a context of negation, or a context of interrogation, what does it benefit? What ruling can I take out of it? Dalalatu al-fadh, the wordings, what evidences are in it, that's how kayfiyatul istifad. Also what falls under kayfiyatul istifad is what? Tartibul adillah. When the evidences need to be seek, they need to be organized. There is a ta'aruf. That there is an opposition between two texts. The way you would know is if this one is stronger than this one, and etc. And also, what do you learn? You also learn, and the letter al-fadhi inshallah is what shows generalization, umum. What are specific, khusus, they show khusus. Things that are mutlaq, things that are muqayyad. You all learn that. You also learn the principle inshallah that we're going to come to. That is, hamlul mutlaqi ala al-muqayyadi. Principle that we're going to take inshallah ta'ala. A specific, narrow down evidence comes. And a generalized, open, wide evidence comes. You take the one that is general and open and you make it on the one that is, meaning the one that specifies takes precedence over the one that's generalized. You see, also texts which are called ammun, it's a general text. When you look at his text, it's general, like in Akhassahu al-Dalil. Evidence is specified it with the sequence and the context that it's in. You see, how to know when evidences are opposing one another. Ma'arifatu tarjih inda ta'arubi. This one is going to take precedence over this one. That's called kayfiyat al-istifad istidlal bilha. And also halul mustafidi. Who is the person? What are the conditions of the mufti, the mujtahid? What conditions does he have to have? When can a person be called a mujtahid? When can we say you are a mujtahid? When can he be it? So brothers, again one more time. Usul al-fiqh deals with three things. Usul al-fiqh deals with three things. The first one is adillatul ijmaliyah, general evidences. It deals with general evidences. Such as al-amru al-wujub, a command shows obligation. Anywhere the Prophet orders you something, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order you to do something, what do you say? It's wajib. Somebody say to you, brother, if a person hasn't studied usul al-fiqh, wouldn't know that. You say, this is wajib. How do you know? Revelation comes to you. How do you know? He'll say that to you. Jahil. Because usul al-fiqh teaches you that the amr, and what do he say to you? Forget the scholars, I don't take them. Just tell me. How does it work like that? These are qawa'id, the principles that the salaf of this ummah, the sahabas and all of them were upon. So what is it? That the person, the amr is wujub. The adilla, which are general, is what usul al-fiqh deals with. Good. The second thing is وَكَيْفِيَّةُ الْإِسْتِفَادَةِ مِنْهَا. How to benefit from those evidences. How? And I said, the way to benefit from them is دَلَالَاتُ الْأَلْفَاظِ. You have to always know the دَلَالَاتُ الْأَلْفَاظِ. Rather, this is the most important part of usul. This is the most important part. That middle one. The second one. It is the eye of usul al-fiqh. Because you sometimes, you might not even be a mujtahid. So you might not need to be mujtahid. And as for the issue of knowing that, and the issue of what? And the issue of knowing that usul al-fiqh deals with adillat al-ijmaliyah, that's sufficient that you guys know it today. That's all that suffices you. Like in the one that's the whole time that's going to take from us. All these chapterings, كَأَقْسَامُ الْكَلَامِ الْأَمْرُ وَالنَّهِ وَالْعَامُ وَالْخَاسُ وَالْمُجْمَلُ وَالْمُبَيِّنُ وَالظَّاهِرُ وَالْمُؤَوَّلُ وَالْأَفْعَالُ وَالنَّاسِخُ وَالْمَسُوقُ وَالْإِجْمَالُ وَالْأَخْبَارُ والقياس والحظر والإباحة وترتيب الأدلة وصفة المفتي والمستفتي وأحكام المجتهدين والمطلق والمقيد. All of them, they fall under وكيفية الاستفادة منها. All of them are وكيفية الاستفادة منها. How to benefit from the evidences. Maybe the last one, وأحكام المجتهدين is وحال المستفيدي. لحال المستفيدي. The حال المستفيدي. The حال المستفيد, which is the third one, is the situation of the person who is a who's a mujtahid. The mujtahid is a person, he's a mujtahid fi madhabin, he's a mujtahid in a madhab, or he's a mujtahid al-mutlaq, he's a general mujtahid, he's etc. We will take. We'll stop there, inshaAllah ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.